Meet Sackabush Jones. He's your typical, everyday, working class Aussie, but he's battling a deep-socketed loss. On March 26th, while conducting routine maintenance on his vehicle, his 10mm socket vanished without a trace. Burdened by a lack of closure and searching for answers, Seka has no choice but to take each day as it comes.
It was a typical Sunday. I decided I wanted to do a few things on the ute, you know, a bit of maintenance. So I went into the garage and I got a few of my tools and sorted them out. And I needed him straight up, so I clipped him straight on and got under there, and we worked together pretty much all morning. He seemed normal, he didn't seem out of character or anything like that. I'd actually hit my head on the chassis getting under there, so we had a bit of a laugh about that. Yeah, you couldn't tell anything was wrong, not that I could see anyway.
But under the surface, something was indeed very wrong.
Yeah, we'd been working together pretty heavily that morning, and I'd come across this one bolt in particular where I needed a different size, so I popped him off and I put the 12 on instead, and like it was really quick, you know, it didn't mean anything to me or anything like that. I just needed it for this one bolt, and I'd be straight back onto him, you know. It didn't mean anything.
But when Seka had returned for the 10mm, he was gone. Vanished without a trace.
He was right there, you know, like he just vanished, you know, like I just reached out for him and then he was gone, right? And I swore he was there, you know, like one minute he was and then next minute he's not, you know, like it's beyond understanding, and he's always been very well rounded, so it doesn't make any sense why he would just get up and go like that. Like, I don't know if he felt betrayed or he was angry. I mean, surely he understands that he doesn't fit every bolt, you know, like, I don't know.
Nearly a month later, the 10mm socket still remains unfound. No contact has been made, and a large black cloud looms over those who loved him.
Yeah, it's probably safe to say that I haven't been dealing with it all too well. I'm drinking slightly more than normal, and I haven't turned a spanner in ages. I mean, what's the point, you know? You don't realise how much you need someone until they're gone, hey? And do you know how common 10mm bolts are? I mean, they're on every fucking thing. You just can't get anything done without the cunt, you know what I'm saying? And just to lose someone you're so dependent on like that, I mean, it takes a toll on you, you know? I mean, and I tried moving on. I mean, I tried the Imperials, but they just don't fit like he did, you know?
Would you say that the two of you had a good relationship?
Oh, look, mate, we had our rows like anybody does, you know? Like, there'd be some days there where he wouldn't grip on as tight as he could, or he'd strip the odd bolt, and I'd give him a fair serve for it and all that, but looking back now, I guess I could have been more kinder, you know, more patient, you know, handled him a lot better than I probably did in the past, but, that's probably how things go, eh? Like, I'll probably spend the rest of my life wondering what I could have done differently, you know, to make him feel more appreciated.
Without any word of warning or even a note, no one will ever know why the 10mm socket decided to roll away and leave it all behind. If he were to be watching right now, what would you like to say to him?
Probably just come home, mate. We love you, we miss you, I'm fucked without you. No one gave head to a bolt like you, mate. Yeah.
Much like his heart, nothing may ever fill the hole left in Seka's socket kit. But hopefully, with time and enough love, this broken down man and his 10mm socket might break the bead of a seized bolt once again. For now, all this bloke can do is hold hope.
Hey, here's the bastard, it's right in front of me the whole time. Fucking hell, look at that. Oh, it's because the top is silver and this is silver as well. It's sort of just blended in there, eh? Well, fuck me, dude. That's a big mob of drama for nothing, isn't it? I'm sorry you fellas had to bring your camera and all that out here, eh? Fuck me, dude. Fucking right there the whole time, eh? Fuck, you wouldn't read about it, would you?